Hey everyone, it's me, Shiken. Today I'm going to be teaching you everything you need to know to get started with Arkham City speedrunning on the PC version. So right off the bat, first thing we're going to do is disable the Catwoman DLC so that you can run categories that don't include Catwoman. First up, you need to figure out where you have the game installed. If you're on the Steam version, you can just go to your library here, right-click on the game, hit Properties, this little pop-up thing, hit Local Files, and Browse. And here you go. You got a little pop-up with the game install location. You can close all this now. From here, you want to go into BM Game, Config, PC, and this is the file you're looking for here, pcgame.ini. You can open this up in Notepad. That's fine. I personally like to use Notepad++, just a little bit fancier. So in this file, you're going to look for the line that says plus DLC bundles installed equals Catwoman. And all we're going to do is we're just going to put two slashes in front of that. And then you're actually going to find this line again at the bottom of the file. Here we see it on line 72. And you're just going to put two slashes in front of that. Hit save, and that's it. You're done. Catwoman is disabled. And if you want to bring her back, all you got to do is remove those slashes, remove these slashes, save, and there you go. She's back. All right, next up, we've got some settings we want to change in the launcher. So to get to the launcher, hit play here. Then with this little pop-up, hit Configure PC Options, and hit Play, and you'll get the launcher here. Just hit Settings. So in the display settings, most of this stuff doesn't matter. One thing that's very important is VSync. You want to make sure this is off, especially if you're running categories that use glitches. The optimal frame rate to play this game at is 62 frames per second, which will be the default as long as VSync is disabled. If VSync's on, then it'll be different depending on the refresh rate of your monitor. And the only other thing that really matters is kind of hidden down at the bottom here with the scroll bar, hardware accelerated physics. Generally, you want to have this off. It can just be kind of distracting. Plus, physics is generally pretty unstable. It can cause some weird issues, some performance problems. So generally, just best have it off. Then over here in the controls section, there's actually a whole bunch of stuff we want to change here. So first step, scroll down to this previous gadget, next gadget thing. You want to just unbind both of these. If you want to bind something else to them, that's cool, but you don't want to use the mouse wheel for that because we're going to use the mouse wheel for a whole bunch of other stuff. So then we're going to find run glide use in this second column here. I'm going to click on this. Then you're going to bind this to mouse wheel up. Then we're going to find counter slash takedown. Again, in the second column, we're going to actually hold shift and then do mouse wheel up. And then we're going to find strike, bind that to shift, mouse scroll down. If you want to bind anything else to mouse wheel, that's okay if you want to. Don't bind mouse scroll down on its own to anything because we're going to use that for something else later. And the last thing that you will definitely need is this aim gadget bind. You'll definitely want something other than right click for aiming, because when you right click, the game prioritizes countering and takedowns over aiming, and sometimes you just want to aim when a takedown or counter is available. You also need the separate bind to do ground takedown cancels. Personally, I like to use a button on the side of my mouse, but use whatever works best for you. As for other recommendations, pretty much everything else comes down to personal preference, but things I definitely recommend doing. If you're only planning to run glitchless, I recommend unbinding toggle crouch. However, if you're running a category that uses glitches, you actually will want this. Down here, there's these variants of select gadget where you're holding shift. This could cause you to accidentally equip the wrong gadget at some points, which could be bad. So personally, I like to unassign all of these. But if you actually use these, then obviously you can keep them. And lastly, I highly recommend binding something to the quickfire gadgets. One is the Batarang, two is the Batclaw, three is Explosive Gel, four is the Wreck, and five is the Freeze Grenades. At the very least, especially if you're running any percent, I highly recommend binding the Freeze Grenades. Personally, I use G. And if you use the keyboard in combat a lot, or just in general a lot, then it can be a good idea to bind these other things too. Now that we're done with the launcher, we're going to make some custom changes to the config files directly. Do note that if you open the launcher again after making these changes, you will lose your custom changes, so make sure you're done everything you need to do in the launcher before doing this step. To find the config files, you're just going to open Windows Explorer here, go to your documents, scroll down to the bottom here, you'll see WB Games, Arkham City, Game of the Year, and from here, BM Game, config, and here you are. So the first file we're going to edit is userengine.ini. So what we're going to change here is actually the language. You'll find it down here under this engine.engine thing. So INT is English. For speedruns, we typically either want to use Spanish or French. For Spanish, you would change this to ESN, and for French, you would change it to FRA. So as of recording this, every category is fastest in Spanish, except for Harley Quinn's Revenge. So for now, we'll just set this to Spanish. While we're here, if you're playing in windowed mode, this game has a problem where you can sort of click out of the game by accident, and then the game will like pause, which obviously loses time. A way you can get around that is by adding B pause on loss of focus equals false right under the language line here. This will make it so if you do click out of the game or you tab out or something, the game will not pause. So like I said, if you're playing in windowed mode, I highly recommend it. So that's all we need to do here. So make sure you save the file before you close it. Next, we're going to go into the userinput.ini file. So from here, you're just going to go to the bottom of the file and you're going to, I'll put these in the description of the video, but you're going to just copy these lines directly. So the first one is just like that. Dot bindings name equals mouse scroll down. And basically we're binding this to a controller button that will allow you to skip dialogue with the mouse wheel. This is why we reserved the mouse scroll down earlier and didn't use it for anything. It's because we're going to use it for this custom edit. Make sure you get the entire line all the way to the end, and that's in here. And the next line is going to be for ground takedown cancels. So if you're planning to only run glitchless, you don't need to worry about this one at all. But same idea. I'll have the thing in the description. You can just copy it and paste it directly in, like so. Should have all this stuff in it. I have it bound to the C key, but you can bind this to whatever, like if you want to use V or B or something else. But I just use C. And that should be all you need to do here. You can save this, exit it out, and your mouse scroll down should work to skip dialogue, and your ground takedown cancels should work. All right, next I'm going to teach you about save file management. First up, you got to get the save file replacer tool and the actual save files themselves. So to get them, you can go to speedrun.com. From here, you can just search Arkham City. Should come up right away. There it is. Here you'll see the leaderboards. There's a bunch of guides, resources, stuff. This is just a very good place to be in general. But specifically, we're looking at this resources page in the sidebar here. And you'll see right here, we've got the save file replacer tool. I already have this downloaded, but you just click on this and it'll download it right away. And then you'll notice a bunch of save files here. These ones are all direct downloads. This one is a link to a collection of save files. In this collection, you'll see some of them are for the Steam or GOG version. Some of them are for the Epic version. You can either download the whole collection or just the ones you need. I've downloaded all the Steam ones onto my desktop here already, so we can get right to using them. So once you've got the save file replacer and the save files, we can get that set up. So just pop open where you have the save file replacer. You'll see savefilereplacer.exe. Double click on this. Then first thing we gotta do is add a game. First instruction is select a directory that contains your own personal save files. So these will be the ones you just downloaded. So I just have this folder named save files. You'll see it's got all the different categories in it. Select folder. Then select the directory that contains the game save files. This might be a little trickier to find. If you're on the Steam version, it's going to be where you have Steam installed. So for me, that's gonna be on my C drive, program files, x86, Steam. And then from there, you go to user data. There might be a bunch of different numbers here. It'll be your Steam user ID. Usually it's easiest to just check them all to try to find the right one, but I only have one, fortunately. And then you're looking for 200260 here. Go into remote, then hit select folder. And we're just going to name this directory Arkham City. And there we go. So you can see on the left, we have our full collection of save files here. And on the right, we have the actual save files you can see in game. So all you got to do to replace a file is, let's say I want to practice lava skip. You can just make sure both of these are selected, then hit this arrow going from the left to the right. There you go. That's all you need to do to replace it. And then let's say I wanted to back up something from this side over to here. You hit this button, makes you pick a name, name it just whatever. And there you go. There's your whatever. And there you go. That's all there is to save file management. And last, but certainly not least, we're going to talk about the timer and the Autosplitter. So this is the timer that most people use. It's called Live Split. It's pretty cool. And it's got the feature to automatically split for you at certain points in the run, which is very useful. So download Live Split. You just got to go to livesplit.org, then hit downloads here, and you can just download it right here. I've already gone ahead and done that. And then the other thing you'll need is the splits specifically for this game. So once again, speedrun.com/ArkhamCity/resources is the ideal place for that. Right down here at the bottom, you'll see splits for the Autosplitter. I've also gone ahead and downloaded that already, and I have all those in this folder called splits on my desktop. So once you've downloaded LiveSplit and extracted the file somewhere, pop open the folder, then you're just looking for this LiveSplit.exe thing. So here's LiveSplit. Doesn't look like too much right now. First, we'll just open up some splits so that the layout kind of fills in here. Just find the splits folder on my desktop. We'll just open the any% splits. So here's everything. You can see all the splits. If you right click on LiveSplit, hit edit layout, you'll notice you have a whole bunch of different options here for things you can add. You can reorder everything. You can also change things like the font of everything, what colors are used, all that stuff. So I highly recommend taking some time, making the LiveSplit layout really look good to you, make it your own, that sort of thing. When you're done with all that, you can also go to edit splits here. You can rename the splits to whatever you want. The names aren't actually important at all. And you can say if you wanted to run any percent hard, you could change this to hard. Or if you just wanted to run a different category entirely, the categories are up here. It is very important that the game says Batman Arkham City here, though, because that's how we connect to the Autosplitter. And you'll notice down here, it says auto start and auto splitting at various points in the story. So to actually get this, all you gotta do is hit activate, and that's it, you're done. You can go to the settings here. You'll notice there are some legacy settings. You don't need to worry about those at all. This is the only setting that matters. If you're planning to choose a skin before you start the run, you will need to have this enabled, otherwise the timer will start at the wrong time and then not start again when you actually want to start the run. And if you are not planning to choose a skin, then you want to have this disabled. And otherwise, you're good to go. So yeah, with all this, you are ready to start speedrunning Batman Arkham City. And if you have any questions about anything in this video or anything in general about Arkham City speedrunning, do not hesitate to join the Discord server. You can find the link in the description of this video down below, and you can also find it here on speedrun.com right here. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. And good luck with your speedrunning.